Happy Friday, guys. Happy Friday. It's Friday.
Feels good to be a Friday. Oh my god, I'm sorry.
I didn't sleep good last night at all. And then the therapist, she had to go to Albuquerque today so she didn't have any patients today. And then I woke up a little under the weather this morning. So it was kind of nice that I just was able to check messages from home today and stuff and just stay home and relax today. But I've got to work Sunday. So I'm off today and tomorrow, but I got to work Sunday. And I've just been kind of like just getting some rest.
I'm sorry.
I am yawning. How awful am I? I'm sorry, guys. You guys deserve better quality videos. But this is me. I want to do some more NF. There's a couple other things I want to do. There's so many. Some Nick Natoli, some more Whit Lowry. There's a lot I want to do. I'm not skipping over a lot of you guys' suggestions. I'm sorry, guys. I will get to them.
This one?
Oh, shoot. Sorry. Is NF Lost in the Moment? And I don't know why. Everything I hear for the first time. So I want to see what he's got going on with this one.
I'll take it in. I'll take it in. This may be the last day that I'll breathe. I'll breathe it in. I'll breathe it in.
I heard that pictures don't change, just the people inside of them do. Whoever told you that life would be easy, I promise that person was lying to you. You got a problem with following through, that's why I got a problem with following you. You keep looking at me like this problem is new, but we've been there before. What you trying to do? Don't talk to me like I don't know what you're feeling. You got a problem with following through, that's why I got...
Sorry, I've already got to stop that one. I don't know, for some reason I've got to go back. I've got to go back and start that from the beginning. That one went so quick for me. I heard that pictures don't change, just the people inside of them do. And, well, definitely that's pictures, you know, because you're just capturing that one moment in time. That one beautiful moment in time that you could never capture again. And that's the beauty of a picture. You know, and some pictures, you know, some pictures that I like looking at pictures. Like when I worked in the Farmington Museum part-time, and they would have local artists that just took pictures. And pictures speak 1,000 words, they really do, you know. You can capture something so beautiful in a picture, or something so real, you know, when somebody's not looking. Or, I mean, pictures are... our memories. And it's so funny, and it's just the way it is, you know. It's like whenever my mom passed away in the beginning of the year,
and we all
we all met at my mom's house after she passed away and stuff. We all went through her pictures and all took our family photos back, you know, like pictures of our kids, our families, or, you know. And it's crazy, you know. You know how you take family photos, or you take pictures, school pictures of your kids, and you give them to grandma, and they save them and everything. And it's, and then when they pass away, you know, you go back, and we each just all took our family photos, you know, because it's crazy that when we leave this world, that's it. Nothing goes with you. Nothing. Not a single thing. But I love pictures. I love pictures. I love to take pictures because I love memories, I guess. You know, good times. When you're having good times, that's what I like. You know, and I look back, I get to see, you know, look at my mom and my dad, and you know, pictures and, you know, my dogs and my kids and just everything, you know, just beautiful scenery, just pictures of where I've been. Pictures are everything. I love pictures. But it's like, you know, that's what a picture is. It's capturing that one moment in time that you'll never capture again.
Whoever told you that life would be easy, I promise that person was lying to you. You got a problem with following through this, while I got a problem with following you. You keep looking at me like this problem is new, but we've been there before. What you trying to do? Don't talk to me like I don't know what you're feeling, cause I was there with you back in the beginning. Quit looking away when I talk, let me finish. I'm trying to be honest, you're trying to forgive me. What's wrong with you, eh? I know that you got a lot on your plate. You're telling me I should get out of your way, but I can't see how you gon' lie to my face. Don't tell me you're fine, cause I know you're not, so don't even try.
Oh, don't tell me you're fine. Don't look at me in the face and tell me you're fine, because I know that you're not. Most of the time, if you know somebody's hurting, and what's hard is you can ask somebody straight up, if you know that they're going through something, and they'll tell you, I'm fine, and you know they're not. But a lot of times, we, as the person asking that, it's our out when they say, I'm doing okay, you know, thank you. Because then it feels like we don't have to sit there and it's sad, because it's so true that it's easier to say, oh, they're doing fine, and move on with your life, when you know they're clearly not fine. And that's what's hard. And I think that's where all this tough stuff comes in, where you can't talk to people, or you can't talk to anybody, or how you feel like you're, if you, you know, you always say, you know, if you're hurting, if you're going through something, just call me, you know. People are afraid to do that, because they're afraid that they're going to get that, like you're being a burden to them or not. And that's tough. And I think that's why a lot of people don't reach out, you know, even to your closest friends and family members. Sometimes you feel like you've probably, they probably just don't even want to listen to you, you know. And it's hard, because, you know, sometimes we all get caught up in our own lives and the busyness of it, that it is hard to reach out, and we forget about those that are important to us. And that's crazy, but it's true. It happens.
Do not pretend like you don't even notice. The funny thing is that you already know it. I'm starting to think that you like how it feels to be lost in a moment.
You ever notice how some people actually do live in the past? It's okay, so I think it stems back to, say your life kind of stopped where you had, where trauma started, where the trauma hit you in your life. You kind of keep reverting back to that time and that age, and sometimes it feels like maybe you haven't matured from that point, but you keep going back to that until you process it and everything. I don't know how to say it, but I know what I'm trying to say. Sometimes at the moment, let's say yesterday something very, very tragic happened to you, and that's where your trauma started, but you didn't realize it. On the outside, you thought you got through the day and it was over with, but then it'll hit you down the line, but you constantly think about it. Oh, I wish I was better with my words with that, because I know what I'm trying to say, because sometimes we revert back to that past behavior at that moment in time where we got hurt, that's where we keep reverting back to. And, you know, they, and everybody says, you can't live in the past. And you can't. We can't live in the past. If we keep letting everything from our past, you know, keep, you know, don't unpack and live there, because that's really going to mess you up. It's, you're never going to be able to move forward. So what you really need to do is, oh my gosh, there goes my dogs. I'm sorry, guys.
Stop it.
Yeah. That's my life. I tell you, my dogs. I'm a old dog lady. But the trauma, you know, but my dogs are my therapy too, though. They're good therapy for me. They're good. You know, these little critters here, they'll protect me with every inch of their being, and they, you know, and I know that. But anyway, it's like, yeah, we can't keep going back living in the past. And a lot of people say, you know, just snap back to reality, you know, just stop it. But sometimes it's easier said than done if you haven't been able to process it.
Eventually, you'll have to deal with the things that you talk about, yeah. But I guess until then, we're lost. Lost in the moment. Lost in the moment. Lost in the moment. And get lost. Lost in the moment. Lost in the moment.
This is all good stuff. This is all good stuff. Lost in the moment. It's like, it's crazy how life can be so busy where we sometimes even forget to stop and breathe. Or what it feels like to take a deep breath in and just be in that moment for a second. Because you're so busy rushing around life, you know, you got so much going on. I mean, who isn't busy? Sometimes our life runs us, we don't run our life. And I don't know if that's a good or a bad thing. I find that here, you know, in America, we definitely, everybody's just about go, 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 busy, busy, busy. I don't have enough time in my day for nothing. You know, chaos, 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 so much of everything. That we stop to miss, we stop and we don't remember what's really important. You know, and I understand that you have jobs and you have, you know, but I remember growing up, we used to eat around the table. Does anybody, how many family, I wonder how many families still do that? You know, how many families still eat around the table and talk and have conversation? You know, and just enjoy that moment. I don't know. You know, I don't know. If your family does that, that's great. It should be done. Me and my sisters were talking because, you know, I was talking to my sister last night and I said, because me and her, my other two sisters, we'd get together and play cards during the day, you know, because we had nothing to do. You know, and then I go and get my full-time job, and now, you know, there goes my card playing days. But I told him, I said, last night, I said, well, we just need to straight up, because my dad was all about family, and that's how my dad was. My mom and dad, they were all about having us together, and my dad loved when all of us would get together and stuff, but that hasn't happened in a long time. Once my dad died, he was the glue that stuck our family to, you know, that held our family together. And when he passed away, everybody started drifting. You know, we all started drifting away. And then when my mom passed away here in January, I haven't seen some of my brothers and sisters since then. And it's like, and I think my dad would be like, what is going on with you kids, you know? I taught you better than that. So I talked to my sister last night and I said, well, me, you, and Tina, you know, we need to each probably say, hey, you know, let's do one night a week, you know, and rotate houses and maybe make, you know, hors d'oeuvres, snacks and stuff, and play cards or play board games or just interact, you know, interact as a, you know, a family. And I don't think that happens nowadays anymore, you know, because even a lot of people say you go into restaurants and stuff, and that's true. Everybody's, you can see people sitting there with their phones. And they're on their phones. It's like, so you could actually be with somebody and not, you're not really there. You know, you can go through a whole dinner, eat everything, but people are on their phones, scrolling through, their life so busy. Those are the moments that you should stop and just reflect and say, hey, you know, appreciate the moment that with the person that you're with, you know, that phone call will wait. I think we've lost a lot of family values. You know, we really have. That's what I told my sisters. I said, we need to really try to get together for holidays because my mom and dad loved that. I remember loving doing that, but it hasn't happened. We haven't had a family get together on a holiday in so long. You know, once our parents passed and stuff. But life is just life, and I know it's hard sometimes to make everything fit. Because I don't see my girls as much as I wish I could. You know, me and my middle daughter gets off the same time as I do, and she works in Durango, I work in Farmington, and she gets off, and I call her, and we kind of talk a little bit on the way home, but sometimes she don't answer her phone, you know. My oldest daughter lives in Albert, her and her husband and stuff, they live in Rio Rancho. And Alex, she's my youngest, and she'll be 17 here in December. And she's got school, she goes to, you know, she's a junior, she works, and then she has college, she's going to have start night classes here in the evening, here in October and stuff, but I miss that time, but I also remember I miss my siblings. I haven't seen a lot of my siblings in so long, you know. But yeah, we need to really try to bring family dynamics back into being important, because I think that's a lot of where everybody's, what's going on. Everybody's so busy, everything is so much, so fast, so much that we don't have time for nobody else. And it's just harsh. And then we wonder what happens to our friends, our families, our loved ones. And it's like, what happened? You know, it's like, and life just slips by you and you miss those moments. You miss those moments. But thanks, guys. I mean, I know I know my channel's different. You know, those that stick with me, that choose to ride with me, I so appreciate it, because it's basically trying to help people through music and know that there's hope and there's love. And not everybody in the world is bad. But maybe we all just need to kind of clean together and just try to make a difference in, and you know, we can't change the world, definitely can't change the world, but we can make it a little bit easier for some people, and that's what I try to do. But that was NF Lost in the Moment, and I can go on forever, but I'm sorry, I'm gonna get this one going. I love NF stuff because he gets me to thinking too, man. Like I said, he gets me to thinking. See, and here I go off on all these tangents from one little song. So, all right, guys, we'll talk to you after a bit. Bye.